Serious doubts have been raised about the effectiveness of the region's leading facility for dealing with young criminals. An offender has admitted to 7 Local News his 9 months in the Cleveland Youth Detention Centre were more like a holiday than punishment. In an exclusive interview, the 16-year-old claimed that rather than turn his life around, he learned more about crime from his detention mates.
Life behind this barbed wire remains mostly a secret until now.
Tell me, what's it like in Cleveland?
That it's not a punishment place. Yeah, all them boys obviously like going back in there.
This young offender was just released after 9 months for stealing cars. He enjoyed playing Xbox and eating regular meals. He says it was like a holiday.
You go to school Monday to Friday, have programs after school. Yeah, like you can do Indigenous art and beads and all that.
The teen insists he's reformed, but did he really just refine his criminal skills?
Did you learn anything about crime from the other juveniles when you were in detention?
If anyone wake up, just want to bash them in the house and that.
So what does it actually feel like breaking into someone's house?
Yeah, a bit scary. You don't know if they sleep or awake when you go into the room.
Townsville has had more than 671 offences for the unlawful use of vehicles this year, and the state government says it's determined to crack down on juvenile crime. It's pulled luxury items like the Xbox from detention. Lawmakers are overhauling legislation and will also trial a new boot camp.
Those are the things that I've talked about in the past, about naming and shaming, making sure that a young person's convictions are accessible to future courts, making bail an offence, a breach of bail an offence.
But the answer might be simpler.
What's it going to take for young people like yourself in Townsville to stop offending?
Sentence for a long time. Well, no more bail.
Eamon Atkinson, 7 News.
Sentence. Long time, where no more bail. Sentence. Long time, where no more bail.